Kiitos, rouva puhemies. Honorable Commissioner Oettinger, democracy is never self-evident. Never. This we should keep in mind. One of the most crucial things, if not the most crucial thing, to sustain democracy in any state is the rule of law. Once the rule of law is questioned, the path to the keys of Pandora's box is open to walk. Because, my dear colleagues, democracy is never perfect. Democracy, through elections, can produce governments and leaders who are tempted to take that walk to Pandora's box and see if they can control it. On their way, they might tamper with the judicial system of the state, or they could find it handy to influence the media, so the journalists would not see it in their best interest to criticize those in power. Or maybe these political leaders would like to introduce laws that make it more and more difficult for civic organizations to go about their activities to express their ideas and worries. In doing all this, these governments and their leaders would clearly be undermining the rule of law, which is the central pillar of democracy. This, unfortunately, dear colleagues, is nothing but a factual description of what is going on inside the European Union today. So, if we want to safeguard democracy itself, we need to safeguard the rule of law. It has been painfully clear for years already that the present available legal mechanisms in the Union do not stop governments on this dangerous path. And this is why we have this extremely important regulation in front of us. We do need a mechanism that will introduce concrete consequences for the Member State in question. And that is why the Commission wisely followed the will of this Parliament, Parliament's MFF resolution, and proposed a budgetary law for co-decision. According to the Commission proposal and to our final report, in order for the Union to protect its financial interests from the risk of financial loss caused by generalized deficiencies as regards the rule of law, the Union should be able to impose appropriate measures that include restricting, reducing, or even suspending access to EU funding in a manner proportionate to the nature, gravity, and scope of the deficiencies. Let me finally underline five things that are most crucial to understand about this legislative report. One, the legal basis for this proposal is in financial regulation, not in Article 7. This is about protecting the EU's budget, the taxpayers' money. Two, we want to write a law that is equal to all member states. The rule of law could be in jeopardy in any member state. Three, we want to protect the final beneficiaries of EU funds. Researchers, civic organizations, ordinary citizens must not suffer from freezing or cutting of funds. Four, we are talking about generalized deficiencies as regards the rule of law. There would have to be clear and widespread undermining of the rule of law before the budgetary consequences could be launched. And finally, five, our report puts Parliament on equal footing with Council through a co-decision procedure of a transfer to a budgetary reserve. With these words, I sincerely hope that every member of this chamber takes a close look at this report. In doing so, I trust that you will find it utmost important to support this proposal and give us a strong mandate for the trilogues. For nothing, nothing in today's Europe is as important as the rule of law. Last but certainly not least, let me wholeheartedly thank and praise my co-rapporteur, Madame Gardiazabal, for her excellent work on this report. Thank you.